Facebook at upcoming OU Athletic Events has been brought to you by Omni OKC Hotel. Your perfect getaway awaits you at the Omni OKC. Patty Gasso in pursuit of history today as she makes her way over to the third base coach's box. With a win today, Coach will become the first coach in any sport to amass 400 career wins in conference play. So a potential record-setting day for Coach Gasso. Coach Steele, Folly Palima Steele over at first. We're ready to go. Jada Coleman digs in. Anthracite jerseys for the Sooners today. And the first pitch is a little bit low for ball one. 12:02 with the first pitch. And thanks for joining us for the Sooner pregame show presented by Walden Cleaners and Laundry, where the difference is quality. The 1-0 to Jada. A little bit out, 2-0. Maddie Wright on Monday night lasted three innings, gave up five runs, four hits, walked five. Sooners drew 13 walks in that first game. Here's the 2-0. Boy, that's not missing by much. Ball three. Bubba Ewald is behind home plate, and he's one of the best umpires, period. So we won't argue too terribly much with his strike zone. It's a 3-0 count to Coleman, and there you go, strike one right down the middle. I feel like with our Trails Golf Club weather report, it's kind of banging the same drum all weekend long. Here's the 3-1 to Jada. She takes strike two. She started making her way down to first base, but Bubba Ewald said, nope, come back here, kid. You got a little bit more work to do. Full count. Knights worked all the way back, and Coleman laces one towards left center field. It's down for a hit. The second straight day where Jada Coleman leads the game off with a single. And here comes the hottest hitting Sooner this weekend, T.R.A. Jennings. Weather-wise, it is 49 degrees right now with a wind out of the north. Northwest at 11 miles an hour. It's not gusting like it did on Friday. First pitch is up high, ball one. Not only is it not gusting like it did on Friday, we haven't quite seen the same winds that we did for our Thursday night batting practice session here at Rocky Johnson Field. The 1-0 to Jennings is in for a strike, 1-1. 49 degrees, it's supposed to warm up to 53. And in fact, they've just updated those winds to around 15 miles an hour. Now is almost on cue. The flag start blowing out to right field as Jennings takes the 1-1 high, 2-1. Weather brought to you as always by the Trails Golf Club in Norman, where you'll experience everything you love about golf and more. And as you might imagine with the weekend she's had, T.R.A. Jennings is our Love's Travel Stops player to watch. The 2-1 pitch with the runner going, Jennings crushes one foul straight behind the press box. Love's Travel Stops, the heart of the highway. What a weekend for Jennings, 5 for 5. 8 runs batted in, 2 home runs, hit them both in Friday's game. She is seeing the ball well. Season average up to 438, ball 3 high. That 438 average for Jennings is good for second on the team. She currently leads the Sooners with 34 runs batted in and is second on the team with 9 home runs. The 3-2 pitch grounded towards third. Nice play by Love. She's going to go across to get Jennings for the first out of the game. Coleman advances to second without a throw. Here's Ella Parker. So we'll be keeping an eye. That's the first time they've retired T.R.A. Jennings this weekend. Love's Travel Stops, the heart of the highway. Here's Ella Parker, a left-handed hitting freshman. Stares out to the circle, waiting the pitch from Maddie Wright, the righty, and she misses inside. Sooners were sensational. I think maybe you could add for the entire weekend they've been sensational with runners in scoring position. One ball, no strike pitch is grounded back up the middle through into center field. Here comes Coleman. She'll score the first run of the game on an RBI single back up the middle from the freshman Ella Parker. It's 1-0 Sooners. Take advantage of RBI opportunities. That's what Coach told us in the keys to the game. And that's exactly what Ella Parker did there. 1-0 Sooners. Here's Brito. Brito, the Sooner right-handed hitting third baseman, digs in. Updated season numbers on Brito as she takes the first pitch. Late jump for Parker, but she slides. The ball hits off her foot. She's safe. It goes into center field, and Ella takes off for third. Give Ella Parker the team lead in stolen bases now. That is her eighth of the season. She's 8-for-9. She takes third on the wild throw that legit hit right off her foot. 4.23 average for Brito as she takes the first pitch, which I believe was strike one. It is. Here's the no ball, one strike pitch to Brito. Takes strike two right on the outer edge. Pretty good spot. It's been a great weekend here in Lubbock for the Sooners softball team. It's been a great weekend in Fort Worth for the OU baseball team. Here's the 0-2 pitch to Brito up high 1-2. We'll check in with Toby hopefully here before first pitch, which is coming up at 1 o'clock in Fort Worth. Sooners have won the first two games. Only undefeated team left in conference play. Here's the 1-2 to Brito. She just gets a piece of it to stay alive. How good have the Sooners been with runners in scoring position this week? This weekend, I guess I should say. We could probably add the Tuesday game if you want. They're 14-for-23. Including an 8-for-11 performance yesterday. Another good cut by Brito, who fouls it straight back. 6-for-12 on Friday night. And then yesterday in the 15-2 win, the Sooners were 8-for-11 with runners in scoring position. The 1-2 nearly hit her up and in. Two balls and two strikes. Fast start here for the Sooners, 1-0 on the RBI single by Parker, who stands at third with one out. The 2-2 pitch, off speed, misses low, ball three. Pretty much the same defensive alignment we've seen for a majority of the weekend from Texas Tech. Villa out in left, Holloman in center, and Elder in right. Time is called. Barnhart at first, Jennings at second, Oric at short, and Riley Love is back at third after we saw the freshman McKenna Mitchell get the start on Friday night. The 3-2 popped up behind home plate. Is that going to get out of play? Is there a play to make? No. About three rows, four rows up. Dad was playing protector. I think it might have just glanced off the little man in the front row. He seems to be okay. Oh, got scared a bit by the foul ball coming close. We'll do the full count again. Here's the pitch. Brito, swing and a miss. Only the second strikeout of a Sooner all weekend long, and there's two away for Sydney Sanders. Sooners put 12 on the board in the first inning yesterday. Friday, they put one so far here, and the first pitch to Sanders misses a little bit in, ball one. 383 average for Sanders on this season, a team leading 10 home runs, 29 runs batted in, which is second to T.R.A. Jennings. Here's the 1-0 pitch to Sanders. Off speed, strike one. Despite the weather and the wind and the cold, solid crowds here at Lubbock all weekend long. The 1-1 pitch to Sanders. Tried to check her swing. She couldn't on a pitch that was up high. Strike two. Patty Gasso asks Bubba Ewald behind home plate if it was on the swing, and Bubba says yes, yes. 1-2 two strikes. And wind again picks up towards right field. The pitch to Sanders, and she lasers one foul. Player of the week for about every single publication and the Big 12 last week for Sid Sanders. See what she can do with this 1-2. Takes it off speed that hangs up high, just a bit high. Sid started to offer at it, thought better of it. Ball didn't come down enough to quite be in the zone. At least from our perspective. The 2-2. That's a really good pitch. Ball three. Three balls and two strikes. Whew. I mean, that's a really good pitch on the inside corner, and I don't know if Sanders could have done anything with it. Coach is saying it hit her. Are we going to get an early McIntyre Law review? Yes. Bubba Ewald motions to home plate. How about that? Sid Sanders got hit in a very similar type of situation yesterday where basically the umpire said, hey, it hit you. Go to first base. And we got another one here. You're going to have an official review. It's brought to you by Noble McIntyre and McIntyre Law, the law firm you should turn to for all of your personal injury needs. My biggest complaint about the broadcast this week, and at least the feed that we have here, is instead of showing us the replay of what they're reviewing, they show us the umpires looking at the replay. So I don't know if we're getting a different feed here in the booth or not, but we haven't seen a replay of any of the controversial calls. And to credit this crew, they're really hasn't been too many. I think this is the first Oklahoma challenge that we've had this whole weekend. I think about Noble McIntyre. I think about that strike he threw last weekend at Love's Field. You think about Noble McIntyre, you should think about the law firm that you should turn to for all your injury needs. Review is still ongoing. We still haven't seen a shot of it. Coach simply asked Sid Sanders, did it hit you? And she nodded, so here we go. This has got to be a tough review based on the angles. Bubba's walking down towards home plate. I'm going to say it didn't hit her. So Christina Drum will head back over to first base. Bubba Ewald behind home plate. Robert Gonzalez standing behind Coach Gasso at third. We'll do it again now. 3-2 count. They say it did not hit her. Runner at third. Two away. 1-0 Sooners. Top of the first inning. Here's the pitch to Sid. Popped up. Shallow left field. It falls for a hit. A little Tex Leaguer over the head of the third baseman Love. Drops into left field. And it's a two-out RBI single. Muscled onto the artificial turf in left field by Sanders. And here's Cassidy Pickering.
Batting for the Sooners, number 7, Cassidy Pickering.
That is RBI number 30 on the season for Sid Sanders. And here is Cassidy Pickering. Pickering out in right field today. First pitch, strike. 2-0 Sooners. Pickering hitting .483 this season with two outs. That's some 50 points higher than her regular average. And she swings and pops this one foul down the left side and out of play. Down that left side in foul territory is the Texas Tech indoor hitting facility. That used to be where they would drop the teams off. They drop you off beyond the trees in left field. The 0-2 is up high. They've built a new parking lot down the first baseline now. That's where the bus will drop the team, and it leads right into that rebuilt first base dugout. The 1-2 pitch to Pickering is low and in, ball two. We had a 30-minute first inning yesterday. The first pitch today at 3 after, is that what we said? 15 so far. 2-2 pitch to Pickering. Ball three up high. Two nothing Sooners. Quick start here in Lubbock. Winds really pick up now. Gusting out to right field. The 3-2 pitch to Pickering is ball four. First walk of a Sooner today on a pitch that was just a bit low, and that'll bring Alina Torres to the plate. We owe you our Riverwind Casino keys to the game. We'll get to those coming up here in moments. Courtesy of Coach Gasso, the first pitch to Torres is popped up. Right field, Elder racing over in foul territory. Makes the catch, and that'll do it for the Sooners. But OU strikes first. They push two across, and as we head to the bottom of the first inning, it's 2-0 Sooners. Nicole May heads to the circle. This is Sooner softball from Learfield. Keys to the game brought to you by Riverwind Casino. Riverwind Casino, always a good time. She's been in the leadoff spot all weekend long. Aubrey Barnhart leads it off as Nicole May stares in. First pitch swinging. She rips one foul down the first baseline. Texas Tech 21-7 now on the season. Their head coach Craig Snyder in his second season. Did a good job in setting a solid foundation for this program last year after winning a national championship at Florida State. Here's the 0-1 pitch as an assistant. Ball low. Polson Tax Resolution and Accounting. Your tax problems don't care who you are, but we do. They bring you our opponent outlook. Sooners have been able to keep the power hitters at bay for Texas Tech this weekend. The 1-1 to Barnhart. Swing and a miss. Fulder, strike two. Barnhart at 322. Their leading hitter, Kaylee Wyckoff, their catcher, the cleanup batter at 407 this season. Riley Love, 10 home runs, leads the team, also 36 RBI. Swing and a miss, strike three. And a first batter strikeout for Nicole May. Polston Tax Resolution and Accounting brings you our preview of our opponents. Tax time, people. Think about Polston. Your tax problems don't care who you are, but Polston Tax does. Here's Ariana Villa. She homered here yesterday. First pitch strike. Villa's home run yesterday was home run number 6 on the season. Well, that's her only hit of the weekend. She's 1-for-5 with that RBI and run scored. Line drive, left field, foul down the left field line. Sooners defense, a familiar look in the outfield. Boone is in left. Jada Coleman in center, and Cassidy Pickering straight away in right field, a few steps in front of the warning track. Deep in the infield, Sanders at first, Torres at second, Jennings at short, Brito at third. The 0-2 pitch. Ooh, they said she didn't go on a ball that was in the dirt. Today's catcher, Riley Ludlam, dug it, ran over and tagged Villa. And while Bubba Ewald pointed down at Robert Gonzalez, he said, nope, she didn't go. May stares at the call on the digital watch. The 1-2 pitch. Oh, that's a great spot. Just a little bit up. Maybe a skosh out. Maybe a skosh. Two balls and two strikes. Sooners playing pretty much straight up, straight away. Not shading via. Deep on the infield. The 2-2 pitch from May. Swing and a miss. Nicole May. Two batters, 2K strikeouts this season. Brought to you by Tinker Federal Credit Union, Oklahoma's largest credit union. Log on to Soonersports.com/kids for information about joining the Sooner Junior Kids Club, presented by OG&E and brought to you in part by Orthodontics exclusively, Mathis Home and Devon Energy. 2-A for Riley Love. The first pitch to the hard-hitting shortstop with the Sooners up 2-0 is high for ball one. I see Big Zilla behind home plate. Went down and met him. The TV broadcast, as I've heard from many of you, has not been updating the count as the 1-0 pitch is grounded foul down the first baseline, just foul. You would think somebody might give the play-by-play guy a heads up that he could update the count a little bit. But how about my man Big Zilla, who's sitting behind home plate, and he is giving the updated count with his fingers. Well, there he goes. One ball, one strike. Here's the pitch. Low and in the dirt, 2-1. I went down before the game and thanked him for his commitment to making sure that Sooner fans could have one less thing to be angry about. Because that's what we're here for. The 2-1 pitch, Love, way out in front of it. Strike two. Cole May's got a good mix going here early. Jen Rocha is dialing it up. Might be a good spot for a little off-speed again. Here comes the 2-2 pitch from May. Missed in the dirt. Full count. May's numbers on the season. 1.60 ERA. She is 8-0. This is her 10th start of the season. The 3-2 pitch for May. All four. Here's Kaylee Wyckoff, the leading hitter for Texas Tech this season.
For the Red Raiders, number 13, Kaylee Wyckoff.
Here we go. Wyckoff, the lefty, digs in. The runner at first and two outs. 2-0 Sooners, bottom of the first inning. First pitch swinging, and she fouls it out in front of the Sooner dugout. Sid Sanders hustles to retrieve it. I got to hand it, at least, knock on wood, at least for now, to the Texas Tech facilities and their ground crew. There was a couple of times throughout the morning today and definitely yesterday where I thought there was no way we were going to play. And we've ended up playing so far without a delay or even too many field issues. The 0-1 pitch is a little bit out. One ball, one strike. Sooners put three hits on the board in the first inning. Scored two runs, now trying to keep Tech at bay with two outs. The 1-1 pitch for May is perfect. Strike two, right on that outer edge. One ball, two strikes. Everyone almost in unison looks down at their wrist to see the pitch call. Again, straight away in the outfield for this 1-2 that missed low. Now they're going to check to see if she went. She did not. And again, one more kind of tip of the cap for now, hopefully not jinxing anything. No one's really complained too much about the field. In fact, no complaints at all with all the weather. The 2-2, little nubber back to May. Gloves, throws, gets her, and Nicole May works around the two-out walk. And Texas Tech goes quietly in the first. Riley Ludlam will lead things off for the Sooners in the top of the second inning. 2-0 OU. Back to work for Maddie Wright, as the first pitch to the right-handed hitting Sooner catcher is up high for ball one.
Sooners 30, Riley Ludlam.
Ludlam hitting 395 this year. She has been the walk queen this weekend, if there's a such thing. 1-0 is low, ball two. She came in after Kinsey Hansen's home run in the second inning on Friday night. Went 0 for 1, but walked three times. And then she walked three more times yesterday. She's ahead on the count here, three balls and no strikes. Ludlam on the season has walked 11 times. Six of those have come this weekend. Three balls and no strikes. Nine-hole Boone waits on deck, then the lineup turns over. Here's the 3-0 pitch to the Sooner catcher. That's a strike. Gray overcast. Get a little sign of some lighter clouds, with an L, not crowds, lighter clouds, off in the distance beyond left field. Ludlam takes ball four. That is the seventh walk that Riley Ludlam has drawn this weekend. Here's Riley Boone. They have several trees that kind of protect the outfield and the view. There's a highway that runs and hospital all around us. As the first pitch to Riley Boone is a bunt attempt that she misses, strike one. Riley double checks with Bubba Ewald to make sure she went. Looks like they've lost a couple of trees in right center and straightaway center field. But it's a really neat setting for this stadium on campus. The 0-1 is bounced to the right of Wright. Hustling to first is Boone, but they get her as Jennings charged. The second baseman throws to first. There's one away. Wright tried to make a play, just got past her. Boone is retired, but it pushes Ludlam into scoring position for the top of the Sooner lineup, and Jada Coleman, who singled and scored a run in her first at-bat. On the weekend for Jada Coleman, not bad now. Four hits in three games. Runner at second, one out, 2-0 Sooners. The pitch lifted pretty deep to left center field. Get out of here, ball! Oh, it's caught at the wall! Leaping and making an incredible catch as Villa. She throws back in, and Ludlam slides in safely. It looked like that ball was gone, and Villa went up and took away a home run. Wow. That might be the best defensive play Texas Tech has made this season. I mean, that's a SportsCenter top 10 kind of a play, and this is really bad news. Riley Ludlam jammed her hand sliding back into the bag. Since we don't get replays, it's either a jammed hand or she was stepped on. Was she stepped on? Thumb? Yeah. Jammed finger. Mara Dickman, the Sooner athletic trainer, is out there working on her. And this is significant. Ludlam has a smile on her face as Mara works on that right hand. Because we don't really know who that emergency catcher might be for the Sooners. Thomas says Alina Torres. I don't know. He may be right. I've never doubted Thomas before. The good news is it looks like Riley's going to be okay because Mara Dickman is an absolute rock star as an athletic trainer. She sprints off the field.
Batting for the Sooners, number 23.
Ludlam is able to make a fist with that hand, so that's a good sign with two away. Oof, scary moment there. And two outs. Here's T.R.A. Jennings. What a play in left field by Villa. First pitch to Jennings is in for a strike. I mean, that ball may have hit off the top of the wall. May not have truly gotten out of here. But she went up and at the very least took away double, maybe a triple from Coleman. And this ball is blasted pretty deep to center field, but at the warning track, Holloman makes the catch, and the wind does not the friend of the Sooners in the second. A fantastic defensive play by Villa leaves the Sooners without a run as we head to the bottom of the second inning, 2-0 OU. This is Sooner softball from Learfield. Hear all their stories at oerb.com/micro. First pitch at the bottom of the second inning is low for ball one. 2-0 Sooners. Two runs on three hits for the Sooners. As Demi Elder digs in. The lefty, right fielder. Takes ball two a little bit up and away. 328 average for Elder on the season. Though a bit of a quiet weekend. There's one for four. The 2-0 is grounded right to Sanders, who makes a sweet play off a hop and steps on the bag for the first out. Reagan Jennings, our media relations guru, Thomas had pointed out the confusion of another team having a Jennings at second base. For me, it was easy. I'm used to seeing a Jennings at second base. First pitch, oh gosh, that is dirty from Nicole May. Drops in for strike one. Abby Orrick waits on deck. No balls and a strike to Jennings. She hit the ball hard here yesterday. Went one for two. Takes strike two. She has a hit in each of the games. I believe she's the only Texas Tech Red Raider that's had a hit in each game. Jennings went one for three here on Friday and one for two yesterday. She rips one off the glove of Torres. It kind of squirts out to the outfield turf, and it'll be a single on a play that Alina Torres typically makes. Just hit off her glove and shot right away from her. Abby Orrick steps to the plate. Martinsville, Texas product.
Number 11, Abby Orrick.
They did indeed rule it a hit. First hit of the game for Texas Tech. On the weekend, just their sixth hit. Orrick takes the ball a little bit out. One ball and no strikes. Runner at first. The pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike one. One ball and one strike to Abby Orrick. Ooh, that's a good spot from Nicole May. Strike two. Alyssa Brito walks in from the third base position to shout words of encouragement towards May. She's off the line here at third, but even with the bag, the 1-2 pitch, unfair. Swing and a miss, got her, two away. Kennedy Kreitz catching today, steps in. Third strikeout of the game for Nicole May. Strikeouts brought to you by Tinker Federal Credit Union, Oklahoma's oldest credit union. First pitch to the right-handed hitting Crates has popped up foul territory. Is there room for Sanders? No. Oh, no, a fan had a glove right behind the dugout. It was his play to make, and he dropped it. And then it rolled off the dugout into the Sooners' bullpen. That is unacceptable. E10 on the crowd. You've got to make that play. Come on. Had the glove, too. Here's the no-ball, one-strike pitch to Kreitz. A little bit out, 1-1. Kreitz didn't catch last night. She did in the opener, went 0-2. Here's the 1-1 pitch. That's in the dirt, and a great job by Ludlam to get in front of it. Great job behind the plate by Riley Ludlam. We didn't see Kreitz yesterday in that Sooner 15-2 win. The 2-1 swing and a miss. Nicole May's Got her pitch mix working. Hurry up, get back, Big Zilla. They got to know the count. Oh, he had a backup. Big Zilla got a backup to make sure that the count was relayed to the fans. There we go. Here's the 2-2 pitch. Grounded softly towards third. Brito up with it, throws wide of first, but Sanders stays on the bag, and the inning is over. I think Tech may challenge this. Craig Snyder is going to walk over. Let's hold it up here a bit. Yeah, Bubba Ewald says he has her on the bag. Nope. Bubba Ewald says he has her off the bag. Hold on, hold on. Now there's confusion. Now there's confusion. They're going to talk. No, he said he had her off the bag. Now I would assume that Craig Snyder is going to challenge this. No. There's not too much of a fit being thrown by Texas Tech here, so it looks like it may have been the right call. Let's watch as they walk over to the dugout and start to debrief. Snyder's going to walk over. He talks to his first base coach. No, they're not going to challenge it. We'll head to the bottom. Oh, we'll head to the third. Third inning shoutouts coming up next. Oklahoma 2, Texas Tech nothing. This is Sooner Softball from Learfield.
At Mission Point Apartments, you'll wake up to a spacious floor plan, upscale amenities, and welcoming pet-friendly community tailored to your lifestyle. Get your daily workouts at the state-of-the-art fitness center. Luxurious amenities and gorgeous grounds make Mission Point Apartments a phenomenal place to call home. And right now, get up to $750 back at move-in. Mission Point Apartments and more, just south of 19th Street on I-35 Access Road. Mission Point Apartments, a Case & Associates property.
The Showplace Theater is the best place for live music.
And with some of the best acts around. Ryan Bingham with the Texas Gentleman, April 19th. Kip Moore, April 20th. Chelsea Handler, May 3rd.
I was with my brother the other day and I said, why are you even a parent? I said, you're not very good at it.
And Brantley Gilbert, May 10th.
Riverwind, the Metro's best casino experience.
Now is the time to experience the difference practitioner-assisted stretching at StretchZone can have on your life. Relieve stiffness and soreness, improve range of motion, enhance physical performance, and start feeling lighter and younger. Plus, for a limited time only, you can sign up for a new Flex membership and get special introductory pricing. Two stretches for as low as $89, locked-in member pricing, no hidden fees, and no long-term contracts. Don't miss this great offer.
Visit Stretch Zone at North Penn Plaza and Chatenay Square.
After the long wait from the Texas Tech dugout, kind of going back and forth on if they were going to challenge the play at first, they decided not to, and we're underway in the top of the third. First pitch to Ella Parker is low and away, skips to the backstop for ball one. 1-0 is grounded foul down the first baseline. Third inning shoutouts is always brought to you by our great friends at Century Roofing. Century Roofing on guard for Oklahoma. CenturyRoofingOK.com. Saw Charisse was first in. Doug Hamilton down in Hockley, Texas. The 1-1 is in for a strike. 1-2. Two runs on three hits for the Sooners. Tech has been shut out. The 1-2, Parker takes the off-speed low. Two balls and two strikes. OU will bus home after the game and get ready for scheduled midweek against UTA. Here comes the 2-2. A little bit up and in. Not by much. That's the key. A little bit. Up and in. Ball three. Three balls and two strikes. The pitch bounced softly to the right side. It'll be a race to the bag between Barnhart and Parker, and Barnhart beats her one away. That'll bring Brito to the plate. Larry's in that St. Pete Sooner den. Curtis asks a great question. Please give us the career stats on Jennings and her team ranking, home runs, doubles, hits, and RBI. Do that. Pile that between innings for you. Maybe even sooner. Thomas is on the case for you, Curtis. First pitch to Brito. Buckles her on the off speed as she takes strike one. Brito struck out in the first inning, just the second Sooner to strike out all weekend long. Here's the 0-1. Brito checked her swing on a ball low. Ron Buckley, Ron and Tracy synced up in McAllister, ask a question. What position did Coach Gasso play? Well, I'll ask you, what position do you think she played? Come on. The 1-1 is lifted deep to center field. Does it have a chance? No, it's caught at the wall again. That's the third, maybe the fourth ball the Sooners have had caught on the warning track up against the wall here today. And it's a long out, two away. Brito is 0-for-2. Coach was a shortstop, but could play anywhere. I learned yesterday that Riley Boone was a pitcher in high school when she was at Edison and Wausau. First pitch to Sid Sanders is in for a strike. But as Jerry Pinley used to tell me, everyone was a pitcher whenever they were playing in high school or travel ball, pretty much. Here's the no-ball, one-strike pitch to Sanders. She grounds this one foul down the third baseline. Sanders singled and drove in a run. Karen Day tuned in out in California. Debbie and J.O. Parker. Montezuma, Iowa. Here's the 0-2 pitch, way outside. Emily Snook has checked in. She has given an online tutorial as to how to sync our broadcast using the Varsity app so you can hear it over the TV call. That's pretty cool. Off speed, hangs up high, 2-2. Marissa and Eric Colquinn listening while cruising to Costa Rica today. Crew at North Road Creations have tuned in. Chad checking in from Gravette, Arkansas. Here's the 2-2 pitch, low and away, ball three. I appreciate the call to violence from Ari Bradshaw, who thinks I need to step over there and tell the Texas Tech announcers to cut it out. They're not here, buddy. It's a remote broadcast. Here's the 3-2, ball four. Yeah, that's one thing that I am grateful for. Coach Gasso allowing it, Sooner Sports property supporting it, Joe C. and his crew supporting it. Remote broadcaster, just not it. It's great to be here in Lubbock, even with the weather. First pitch to Cassidy Pickering is inside. We had our pregame call to check in from Cassidy's grandparents, who are tuned in from Willow Creek, Montana. Sunny and dry there today. 1-0. Boy, she took everything off that. Strike one as it dropped in. Two nothing Sooners. We're in the top of the third inning. Third inning shout-outs rolling through this inning, brought to you by Century Roofing. Here's the 1-1 pitch to Pickering. Low and in the dirt, 2-1. Kelly's down in Florida, Kelly and Kim Walker in Perry, Florida. Randy Ritchie's got his ears on, as is OU Love, and my man OU Loves, and my man Nate Dogg. He's hanging out with Warren G today. Here's the 2-1 pitch, in for a strike, 2-2. Pickering, her last time up, walked. She was stranded on the flyout by Alina Torres, who waits on deck. See if Pickering can just lose one here on a 2-2 pitch. She pops it up to center field, but it's not going to be deep enough. Hollerman under it makes the catch, and it's a quick third inning for the Sooners. We'll head to the bottom of the third. Sooners on top, 2-0. Today's game broadcast is presented in part by Love's Travel Stops and our OU Community Outreach Partners. Logan Hollerman will lead things off for Texas Tech. Nicole May's been solid through two. Oklahoma's lead is 2-0. It'll be Hollerman, Barnhart, and Villa. As this game pushes towards the one-hour mark, first pitch to Holloman is in for a strike right on that outer edge. Same defensive alignment for the Sooners. Sanders at first, Torres at second. Jennings playing straight away at short. In tight at third is Brito. Couple steps in. Here's the 0-1 pitch. Bounce softly towards third. Brito up, throws, got her. The speedy Holloman is retired on the second straight. Nice play made over on the left side by Alyssa Brito, and there is one away. All right, Curtis, just for you, just for you, because I appreciate you. Tiara Jennings, 82 home runs, currently third all-time in Sooner history. She's tied with Sid Romero with her 58 career doubles, second all-time in Sooner history with career runs batted in with 279, and seventh all-time in Sooner history with 272 hits. Top of the lineup, Barnhart rips one foul. She needs 13 home runs to tie Lauren Chamberlain for second in Sooner history. She needs 44 runs batted in, which I think is doable, to tie Jossie for first place all-time in OU history, and she's chasing the top five in hits in a career. As the 0-1 pitch to Barnhart is grounded foul. She needs four hits to tie Christy Ring for sixth in Sooner history. And with two more home runs, she would enter the NCAA top 10 for all-time career home runs, which would tie her for 10th with Shelby Pendley. Thank you, Thomas. Great question, Curtis. It's pretty impressive what Tiare's done. The 0-2, ooh, that hit Barnhart, and she went down hard. It hit her right on the elbow, and she is not wearing an Evo shield. And she is down on the ground in pain. Sits up. Well, she does have an Evo shield on. She was just wearing it up her arm a bit. It caught her right underneath it. She's trying to shake it off. Athletic trainers for Texas Tech are out. The Red Raiders will have a runner aboard for the third straight inning. And Barnhart in the leadoff. Surprisingly, not the speed demon. She hasn't attempted a stolen base this season. And as Barnhart still appears to be in pain, the athletic trainer is watching. Okay, the first base coach said, come on. And I was like, wow, that's they're making her tough it out. She just walked on to step on the bag, and Texas Tech will bring in a pinch runner here for Barnhart. We'll see if she's able to return. Chastity Rains. Rains will pinch run. And that'll put a runner aboard for Ariana Villa. Homered here yesterday. She represents the tying run with the Sooners on top, just 2-0 here in the bottom of the third inning. We approach the 1 hour mark for this game today. Here's the first pitch to Villa. It's up high, ball one. Ah, Brooks got us synced up in Norman today. Ground ball right side. Diving play made by Torres. Sanders gets back to the bag, but not in time. A head first slide at first. And Villa is safe. Sanders went to make the play. Torres made a diving play. Sanders raced back to the bag. And as Villa slid in head first. Wait, hold on now. Patty Gasso is going to go out. We may have a challenge here. And if we don't have a challenge, you know, Coach Gasso, we were talking about this with the great Ryan Wondrasik. Coach Gasso has done a great job in not using challenges. And by that, the umpires can review any play as many times as they want. And if there is any kind of question, Coach does a solid job of not necessarily going out and saying, I'm challenging that, but what did you see? What did you think? How close was it? And it's one way in which you can, I'm not using the word manipulate, but where you can kind of maybe talk an umpire into reviewing it without using up one of your challenges. And I think that's what happened here based on Christina Drum's reaction, the umpire over at first. But it may also be a challenge from Coach. Regardless, it's another review, our third already, brought to you by McIntyre Law, and it's a quick one. They're going to say that she's safe. Quick review there. Noble McIntyre and McIntyre Law, the law firm you should turn to for all your personal injury needs. Sevilla reaches on the infield single on a heck of a play made by Alina Torres. Sanders was just a little bit too far off the back to race back as she thought it might be her play. And the Red Raiders have put runners at first and second with one out. And Riley Love, their big home run hitter. First pitch, a little bit up and in, ball one. See Nicole May work out of this jam. Best scoring opportunity the Tech has had since the bottom of the sixth inning on Friday night when they loaded the bases with nobody out. One ball and no strikes to Love, who walked her last time up. Swing and a miss. Good pitch. One ball, one strike. Love looks down at Craig Snyder. Two nothing Sooners, but the Red Raiders threatening. The 1-1 grounded sharply through into left field, rounding third and holding there is the pinch runner, Reigns, and the bases are loaded. Again, Tech, a C9 single right through the left side, got between Jennings and Brito, and the bases are loaded for Wyckoff. And the antennas are up here for Oklahoma. They'll bring the infield in. In fact, the entire infield will head to the circle to talk this one over. Gives us a chance to catch up on thanking those of you who have tuned in. Kenneth Sumter with the boys out on the Illinois River. How about that? Traylon DeCur is tuned in. There's Brooke Luker, Chris Day, Jada's uncle back in San Antonio. Saw Chris here on Friday night. Miss Jane Jetson is in Dallas. Dwayne and Stacy listening to in Arlington, Texas. Christy is in Cherokee Reservation in Tahlequah. Here we go. First pitch to Wyckoff is in for a strike. Each team now has three hits. Tech has two of them here in the third inning. The 0-1. Grounded back to May, off her glove, then bobbled by Jennings. Everybody safe. The runner rounds third, heads home. She's going to be out by a mile. As they tried to get a bonus run, Villa tried to push it, and Jennings recovered in time. Some unsooner-like moments there, but there's two away. It's 2-1. That ball was a tailor-made double play ball right to May. And then off May's glove, right to Jennings. She just couldn't corral it. It ends up with a tag out at home, but not before the Red Raiders score their first run of the game. First and third now. Two outs for Demi Elder. And the first pitch misses, ball one. Those are tough plays, the reaction plays, when they're right back at you. Patty Gasso calls time. She's going to bring the infield together. Patty's talking, Coach Gasso's talking to the infield. And for a moment, because she's away from the circle, Nicole May was going to the meeting with the four infielders. And Coach Gasso said, no, just a second, Nicole. Jen's going to be right out there. Nicole May's pitched well. Had some just odd defensive moments for the Sooners, rear their ugly head here in the bottom of the third inning, even earlier in the game. The second inning hit by Reagan Jennings is usually a play that Alina Torres makes. The one out single by Villa was a play where Sanders went to make the play, but Torres ended up making a diving play, and Sanders couldn't get back to the bag in the time. And then a ball that just ricochets right off May's glove to Jennings. Meeting's over. Here's the 1-0. That's in for a strike. 1-1. Patty Gasso probably also realizing this first and third situation. The Sooners have been so effective at it. They wanted to make sure the Sooners are all in on understanding how to defend it. If Tech tries to run it, they won't hear on the 1-1 pitch that misses low and away, 2-1. The Boone family, Gala, and the crew have checked in. They're watching the Sooners and have us synced up. Sun shining in broken air. Bragg. Here's the 2-1. Grounded to the right side. Torres has it on a big hop. Throws to first, inning over. But Tech gets back in the game. 2-1, Sooners lead it as we head to the fourth. This is Sooner softball from Learfield. Softball presented by Love's Travel Stops, the heart of the highway. Today's game is presented by the OU Community Partners, Fowler Auto Group, OG&E, OU Health, and Coca-Cola. The University of Oklahoma Athletics is one with you. Kelly Bryce has checked in. There's Jessica Bame in Ohio cooking up a storm on this St. Paddy's Day. Rick and Kathy True Love, they're cooking up corned beef and cabbage in Nashville. Jim and M, Sapphire Beach and St. Thomas, thanks to Kyle Davis. We went back and watched that replay. Don't know if on the home run it was going to get out of here for Riley, for Jada Coleman, but it was still a heck of a catch as the first pitch is in for a strike to Alina Torres to start things in the fourth. Alina flied out to right field. Warren and Sheila Blankenship are at Astros spring training. Saw your guys' great pictures from that with the AirPods in. The 0-1 is grounded foul. Bruce Burdett and the Sooner fans out in Birmingham. Todd's in Duluth, Georgia. Larry, Big Sky Sooner, and TJ are watching from Noble America, the home of the great Chris Wilkerson, Noble rock star. Here's the 0-2 pitch to Torres up high. Alicia Stallcup, my sister, is tuned in. Cade's birthday party. She got in before the rest of the family. Sorry, Mom. Here's the 1-ball, 2-strike pitch to Torres. Reaches, grounds it back up the middle and through. It's a base hit. Torres just gets it over the mid on the hopper of right. And let's check and see if Barnhart is not back in for Texas Tech as Riley Ludlam will step to the plate, and Patty Gasso will use a pinch runner here. So let's check the current defensive alignment for Texas Tech after it looks like Barnhart is at least done for now. She can't re-enter.
Number 82, Avery Hodge.
They have gone ahead and over at first base. It's like D. McClarity is over at first base now.
Batting for the Sooners.
And that looks like Riley the only Ludlam change. So D. McClarity in at first base. And here's Riley Ludlam, who, guess what she did? She walked her first time up. First pitch, runner fakes going. It's strike one as Avery Hodge is the pinch runner here. So likelihood is pretty high that we'll see Hodge stay in and play second base in the bottom half of the fourth and maybe beyond. Here's the 0-1. Low and away, 1-1. Hope everything is okay for Barnhart. She's been a constant in this lineup for the Red Raiders. The 1-1 is way up high, 2-1. 2-1, Sooners lead it, each team with four hits. Tech has played out of its mind defensively so far. Balls that have typically left the yard this week and have come up just a bit short for the Sooners. Here's the 2-1. Swings and fouls it at the plate. My man Shane Sanders checked in. He's the one who introduced us to the We Play 5 shirts. Redhead Sooner, always driving through Oklahoma's back roads and tuned in. See if they can bring us a little luck here. The 2-2 pitch to Ludlam. She swings and hits a fly ball to relatively deep center field. The catch is made. 1-1. I did get a check-in from the booth. Ryan, Gabby, and Thomas have all checked in. That's pretty impressive. Ryan wants nothing to do with being around me on game day. It's the last place he wants to be is right next to me. Riley Boone steps to the plate.
Batting for the Sooners, number zero, Riley Boone.
Here we go. 2-1 Sooners. Booner last time up, grounded out back to the pitcher. First pitch, low and away, ball and one. One ball and no strikes. Hodge the pinch runner at first after the leadoff single by Torres. Here's the 1-0 to Boone. A little soft slap. She missed it. Runner goes to second. She snags the bag safely to Hodge. The throw was right at the bag, but like no one was at the bag. And it actually hit off Hodge or it would have went to center field. It's a stolen base. Ball and a strike. One ball, one strike. The pitch. Boone lines one to left center field and deep, but it's caught on the run, of course, by Holloman. Hodge tags on her way to third. She slides in safely. Every ball the Sooners have hit to the outfield, be it a deep fly ball or a line drive, Texas Tech has made a play, and that was a good one in center by Holloman. Kevin Goodmiller has checked in. Happy St. Patrick's Day. I'd go for Thanksgiving today. Larry and Danita Higgs of Prague, Oklahoma. Michael Crow checking in from Warsaw, Poland. Thanks, guys. Appreciate it all. All right. Jada with a runner at third and two outs. Stepped out of the box in the middle of that lollipop change to take strike one. She wanted nothing to do with that. Jada's one for two on the game. A leadoff single scored. One of the two first-inning runs for the Sooners. Here's the 0-1. That's low. One ball, one strike. Jada's season average is up to 4.23. Two outs. She's sitting 3.12. Bulky 5.62 average with runners in scoring position. The 1-1 is, again, that off-speed. That drops in for strike two. Wright stares in, brings it to her belt, rocks and fires up high, 2-2. Tiare Jennings waits on deck. Lights are on here on a dreary, overcast, gray day in Lubbock. 2-2 is lined to left field, but guess what? Villa makes an incredible racing in catch again. I mean, the Sooners are hitting it on a line, and Tech is right where they need to be. Stop me if you've heard that before. We head to the bottom of the fourth inning, Oklahoma 2, Texas Tech 1. This is Sooner Softball from Learfield.
And we're back with the action. Coke Zero Sugar might be the best Coke ever?
That's right, Jim. With an irresistible taste and zero sugar, Coke Zero Sugar is a must-try for... Aw, Jim!
Best Coke ever? Take a taste, Jen.
We're still on the air.
Cruise In Auto Spa, Norman's Car Wash, Detail, and Oil Change Center, where you can get the 7-day clean car guarantee. Now you can join the Cruise In Mobile Text Club. Text OU Free Wash to 855-592-0764 and receive a free car wash courtesy of Cruise In Auto Spa. Located at 1235 West Main in Norman, make sure to visit their website for more information, cruiseinautospa.com. Messaging and data rates may apply.
Shh. It's yoga with Drake Stoops and Kendall Daniels.
And exhale. Tune in to your chakras.
Yo, Drake, you feeling this yoga stuff?
Kendall, dude. I feel wonderful.
How are you so calm?
I got that Schwab swagger.
Schwab swagger?
Here, try this Schwab dog.
Get your swag on with Schwab Meat, the official mouth-watering hot dog of OU and OSU athletics.
Namaste.
Get a quick three up and three down and get back in the dugout as Texas Tech will send Jennings, Oryk, and Kreitz. Weekend that's been all Sooners. Red Raiders have played great defensive softball today and have taken advantage of a couple Sooner mistakes, but it's 2-1 OU, and the first pitch to Jennings is fouled back. She singled her last time up. The Trails Golf Club offers the perfect atmosphere for great golf and family fun. At the Trails, you will find golf at its best and social events to enjoy all year. Entertain clients, enjoy friends, make family memories at the Trails Golf Club. Visit trailsgolf.com. The 0-1 pitch from May is in the dirt. Sooner softball also brought to you by OG&E. We energize life. And MidFirst Bank, a premier partner of OU Athletics and your exclusive home for the OU debit and credit card. Visit midfirst.com/Sooners for details. Member FDIC. The 1-1 pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike two. May, three innings, scattering four hits, has struck out three, walked just one. And the only run by Kansas State, or by Texas Tech, came in the third inning. One ball, two strikes. Here's the pitch. Line drive, caught by Hodge at second base. One away. Ball off the bat, looked like it was destined for shallow right field, but Hodge makes the play. So, as we speculated in the bottom half of the third, Avery Hodge is officially in now at second base. So that infield is Sanders at first, Hodge at second, Jennings at short, Burrito at third, with May pitching and Ludlam catching. The first pitch to Oryk is grounded towards third, under the glove of Burrito, past Jennings into left field. That's a play that Burrito has consistently made this season, and for some reason today just got under her glove. Jennings trying to back it up, couldn't get there. And it's the fourth hit of the day for Texas Tech. Here's Kreitz. 2-1 Sooners. We're in the bottom of the fourth inning. Each team with four hits. OU has been docked an error. First pitch, swing and a miss.
Batting for the Red Raiders, number 8, Kennedy Kreitz.
Kreitzer last time up, grounded out to third. Could go with a little nice 5-4-3 double play here. Get us out of this fourth. Good pitch. A little bit too high up. Ball one. That's a hit, okay. That's the fifth hit now for Tech, so no error. So five hits for Tech, four for Oklahoma. 1-1 in the dirt. Good job by Ludlam. Two balls and a strike. This might be kind of hard to tell if we're still getting any of that mist. Doesn't look like it. The most pleasant day we've had here at Texas Tech. Here's the 2-1 pitch for May. Grounded to the right side to Hodge. Slow roller. She ran into the runner who will be called out. That was a smart play by Hodge. She ran into the base runner, and that's an automatic out. Now we'll see if there's going to be any debate. Craig Snyder walks. As Hodge was going to try to make the play, she collided with Oryk, and it's now the umpires are going to come together. I don't think this is something that you can necessarily challenge. No review here, but it'll give us a chance to talk about Noble and McIntyre Law, the law firm you should turn to for all your personal injury needs. The fielder has to have a path to the ball. Now, Christina Drum is talking to Craig Snyder. This should be the second out of the inning with Love out at second. And is it fair to say maybe that Hodge could have made a play without running into the base runner? Maybe. But, oh, they are going to review this now. So, we'll see. This game has hit an absolute slowdown mode mindset. As, again, instead of getting the actual replays, we get the shots of the umpire looking at replays. You have to give the fielder a chance to field the ball. And the two collided. Now, are we really kind of like splitting hairs if we're trying to figure out intent here? I don't know if they're going to be able to figure that out from a review or not. But Drum and Bubba Ewald are talking over it. This should be, it's the difference between runners at first and second, the tying run at second and one out, and a runner at first with two outs for Texas Tech, and the nine-hole hitter Holloman coming to the plate. The McIntyre Law review is over. Let's see. Bubba Ewald makes his way out. Christina Drum will make the official call. They're going to say out. Yep, there you go. So Abby Orrick is retired. Kreitz will reach on the fielder's choice. So interference.
Batting for the Red Raiders, number 7, Logan Holloman.
Here's Logan Holloman now with two outs. That'll work in the Sooners' favor. First pitch, a little bit out. Holloman on the day is 0 for 1, grounded out to third on a slow roller. Here's the 1-0. Shows bunt, takes it outside, ball two. Two balls and no strikes. Swing and a miss, strike one. A runner has committed interference when the runner denies a defensive player a reasonable opportunity to make a play by physically contacting that fielder and prevents them from fielding a fair batted ball. Foul ball or foul ground ball. A little soft slap foul, strike two. The fielder must have a reasonable chance to make an out. A fielder cannot initiate the physical contact in order to draw the interference call. And that's maybe, and that is what I'm sure Craig Snyder is arguing here, but the Sooners win that argument. Big pitch here from Nicole May, the 2-2. A little bit low, full count. So the question here is whether or not Hodge may have initiated the contact. We do got to work on our acting a little bit. Here's the 3-ball, 2-strike pitch from Nicole May. Line drive off the glove of May. Ricochets to Hodge. No play anywhere. That's just kind of how this day has been. Holloman is aboard, and she's a speed demon. 6 hit. And this will be the first at-bat of the day for Dee McClarity, who is in for Aubrey Barnhart, who was hit by a pitch in the third.
Pitch running for the Red Raiders, number 36, Gabby Rawl.
So, add a pinch runner here, too.
Adding for the Red Raiders, number 20,
as they have put Gabby Rolls now at second base for Love. And the first pitch to Dee McClarity in her first at bat of the weekend is up high, ball one. A weekend that has been all Sooners is suddenly in a little bit of peril. As Tech has put the tying run in scoring position and the go-ahead run at first base. 2-1. Sooners, though, still lead it. McClarity, a .233 hitter on the season. Here's the 1-0 pitch from Nicole May. Up high, 2-0. There is activity in the Sooner pin. Looks like Carly Keeney getting some work over there for the Sooner. She was fantastic yesterday. This inning started with a little looper to Hodge at second. There's a strike, 2-1. Then a single by Abby Yorick. The fielder's choice by Kreitz on the interference call. And Holloman with another ball that hit off the glove of May. 2-1 pitch from Mayday. Strike two. Two balls, two strikes, two away. 2-1 Sooner lead. They've been out hit. See if May can get him back into the dugout. Long look by the senior. Rocks, fires, got her! Swinging, inning over! First pitch swinging to start the fifth inning. T.R.A. Jennings pops one into shallow right field. Easy play made by Elder. And just like that, to start the fifth, there's one away for Oklahoma with the Sooners on top, 2-1. Fifth innings this season. Brought to you by the Hal Smith Restaurant Group. There's Ella Parker. First pitch to the left-handed hitting DP is low for ball one. Parker had a single that drove in the first run of the game, stole a base, and then scored on the two-out RBI single from Sid Sanders, the only offense for the Sooners so far. A 1-0 pitch, inside corner, strike one. Parker jumped away from it to try to sell it a little bit, but Bubba Ewald said, no, that's a strike. Here's the 1-1. Low and in, 2-1. Visit howsmith.com/restaurants to learn more about their incredible group of tasty restaurants, Louis Bar and Grill, Mahogany, Neighborhood Jam, Pub Dub, Toby Keats, I Love This Bar and Grill, and others. 2-1, up high, ball three. That's one area today to give credit to what Matty Wright has done in the circle. Sooners have only drawn three walks on the weekend heading into today. They had drawn 21 walks in two games. One away in the top of the fifth. 2-1 game. Sooners lead it. Here's the 3-1. Parker hits it hard to the right side. Backhand play by Jennings. Throws it wide. It gets away. Parker's on her way to second. The catcher drops the ball. And it's a one out. We'll await the ruling. Single. Probably going to be an error on the throw. But Parker never stops running and takes off for second. And she's in scoring position with one away for Alyssa Brito, who is due. And I mean, she is due.
Batting for the Sooners, number 33, Alyssa Brito.
They did indeed rule it an error, E4. Parker was cooking down that line, though. Come on, Brito. Let's go. First pitch to Alyssa is hammered. Deep to left center field. There is no doubt about that, baby. It leaves the yard. A two-run bomb. A Brito bomb has made it 4-1 Oklahoma in the top of the fifth inning. That was an absolute bomb. A blast, a laser, a nuke. The first home run of the day for the Sooners, and it's a big one. Gives them some breathing room. It's now 4-1. And after
batting for the Sooners, number one, Sydney Sanders.
Friday night, when the Sooners hit four home runs, two from TRA, a home run from Hanson and Torres. Just one yesterday, and now the first one today from Brito. Home runs this year brought to you by the hardworking people of Oklahoma Oil and Natural Gas. 4-1 Sooners. First pitch up high, ball one to Sid Sanders. Right stairs in. Here comes the 1-0. Sanders takes strike one. For Alyssa Brito. Home run number 8, RBI 23-24 on the season. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Little fisted shot, looper to first base, easy play for McClarity, and there's two away. Sanders now 1-for-2 on the day. And that'll bring Cassidy Pickering to the plate.
batting for the Sooners. Number
2
seven,
outs and nobody
Cassidy
on.
Pickering.
What a shot by Vrita. Sooners desperately needed it. First pitch to Pickering, up high, ball one. Just a weird day. Some of the defensive, I don't even want to say miscues, but just kind of tough breaks the Sooners have had. The 1-0 pitch to Pickering is in for a strike, 1-1. There is no wind here to speak of, which is wild based on what we've dealt with all weekend long. The flags in center field are at rest. Scoreboard in right center field. 1-1 is in for a strike, strike two. I don't think Pickering liked that too much. Cassidy's 0-1 with a first inning walk, and she flied out to center field in the third. This game rolls past the hour and 30 minute mark. It's 1:34. Here's the 1-2 pitch to Cassidy. Swinging, just gets a piece of it. Ball ended up right underneath Bubba Ewald. Neither he nor Kennedy Kreitz, the catcher, could find it. So Cassidy Pickering reached out and picked it up. Pickering wanted to confirm from Bubba that she swung at a strike. He gives her a smile and nods. This is the only Big 12 series that Bubba Ewald has for the Sooners this year. It's kind of wild. Here's the 1-2 pitch from Maddie Wright to Cassidy Pickering, way up high, 2-2. Bubba, Tim Kuykendall, 1-1A in the Chris Plank umpire rankings. These are very famous rankings. Bubba said we won't see him again. Well, Wednesday, he's got the call Wednesday. The 2-2 pitch to Pickering is popped foul. His crew will be in for UTA, and then we won't see him again until the postseason. Behind home, Christina Drum at first, Robert Gonzalez over at third. A 2-2 pitch to Pickering is a call strike three on an absolutely nasty off speed that fooled Pickering. She's frustrated. She'll jog back to the dugout. The Sooners will take the field with a little bit more juice. 2-run home run in the fifth from the third baseman, Alyssa Brito, has given the Sooners a 4-1 lead. As we head to the bottom of the fifth inning, this is Sooners softball from Learfield. All right, it's 4-1 Sooners. Tighter game than we've had all weekend long as we head to the bottom of the fifth inning. Ariana Villa will lead things off. 2, 3, and 4 hitters for Texas Tech. Villa, first pitch from Nicole May, is a little bit out. Ball one. Villa's 1-for-2 on the day. She was thrown out on an overly aggressive attempt to score from second base on an infield mistake by the Sooners. The 1-0, she couldn't stop her swing. Strike one on a pitch in the dirt. Villa has one of the two home runs that Tech has hit this weekend. Digs in with a 370 average in a game that has a much different feel than any of the games we've played against Tech in Lubbock this year. The 1-1. Pop foul down the left side. Friday night was not a run rule game either. And in the previous three meetings last year in Norman, the Sooners didn't run rule Texas Tech. Probably kind of gives you an idea of where Sooner softball is in relation to Tech. The 1-2 pitch in the dirt. It's a celebration whenever they don't find themselves getting run ruled. Two balls and two strikes. May rocks and fires. Swing and a miss. Got her. Nicole May getting stronger as the game gets longer. Fifth strikeout of the day for Nicole May. Second straight. One away for Riley Love. When you can't be at the game, Sooner Sports TV has you covered on the air and online at Soonersports.tv. Sooner Sports TV presented by our cornerstone partners, Anheuser-Busch and OU Health. First pitch to Riley Love. Hits her. That has been a bit of a problem for Nicole May trying to come up and in today. That's the second batter that she's hit. Five strikeouts, one walk through four and a third so far, but two hit by pitches. And here's Kaylee Wyckoff, singled her last time up. She's 1-for-2. By the way, Riley Love, as she stands now at first, has reached every at-bat so far. First pitch, Wyckoff hits one deep to right center field. Jada Coleman, though, races over, makes the catch, and there's quickly two away. Two away for the right fielder, Demi Elder. Well, one thing we haven't done yet in the broadcast is check scores of some other games. How about OU baseball? Bottom of the second. James Hitt has been pretty good so far for the Sooners. Well, we're in the bottom of the second. We're just getting it away. But it's 2-0 Sooners. Looking to sweep the series in Fort Worth for OU baseball. Here's Demi Elder. First pitch swinging. And she fouls it off for strike one. Elders 0-for-2. Ground out to first. Ground out to second. She's been all over that right side today. No ball, one strike pitch from May is headed home. In for a strike, 0-2. We will be in operation get out of town for the Bud Light postgame show. 0-2 count with a runner at first and two away. May fouled off. Two other games in the Big 12 today. Kansas leads in the bottom of the sixth inning, 1-0 over Baylor. Let's get an updated score on that. That might be final by now. Here's the 0-2 pitch from Nicole May to the lefty Elder. Well, a little bit out. Top of the seventh, Kansas 1, Baylor nothing. How about that? And Oklahoma State will head to the sixth inning with a 5-1 lead over UCF after, the UCF blow an opportunity yesterday. Here's the 1-2 pitch from May. Soft grounder to first. Sanders gobbles it up, steps on the bag, inning over. We head to the sixth, Oklahoma 4, Texas Tech 1. This is Sooner softball from Learfield. Sooners, as we head to the sixth, Avery Hodge will get her first plate appearance of the game.
Number 82, Avery Hodge.
It'll be the 7, 8, and 9 hitters for the Sooners, Hodge, Ludlam, and Riley Boone. Off Maddie Wright, who's been pretty good today for Texas Tech after the Sooners hit her around the other day. First pitch a little bit out, ball one there in tight on the Texas Tech defense. McClarity has been in at first since the fourth. She came charging in here in the top of the sixth inning on that bunt attempt by Hodge. A 1-0, a little bit up. Avery's season average stands at 276. She's drawn three walks, has driven in five runs in that second base platoon. That's been her and Alina Torres, and we've seen Quincy Lilio there, who stands on deck at times. Here's the 2-0. Hodge shows bunt, pulls it back, takes ball three. Four runs on five hits for the Sooners, a run on six hits and an error for Texas Tech. 3 balls and no strikes. Pitch, strike one. 5 innings for Maddie Wright so far. 5 hits, 4 runs, though only 2 of them are considered earned right now. 3 walks and 2 strikeouts, which is doubled the number of strikeouts Tech pitchers have had this weekend. There's a bunt that's foul as Hodge waited and waited, and she's got a smile on her face. Just bunted it foul at the plate. That popped up and caught Bubba Ewald. Make sure that she's okay. Kreitz is going to use this opportunity to jog out and say something to Wright. Little glove bump from the shortstop, Abby Ork. We're ready to go. 3 balls and 2 strikes. Here's the pitch. Little looper, left field, base hit. I mean, Avery Hodge is learning that bat control. And she dumped one in the left field, and there was nothing that Villa can do, who has caught everything that has been hit out to left field today. Here's Q Lilio, who's going to get in at bat.
For the Sooners, number 43, Quincy Lilio.
It's Q done this weekend. Pinch hit yesterday on Friday. Ended up staying in the game. Went 0-2 with an RBI and a walk. Bases loaded walk. And she takes the first pitch for strike one. Didn't see her yesterday. But she gets an opportunity here with nobody out in the top of the sixth inning and the Sooners up 4-1. Hodge at first, the 0-1 pitch. Q takes it. One ball, one strike. I look at the clock. I see 1:47. I'm already getting nervous for, what is that, 4 o'clock today when the field will be announced? The most recent update on March Madness for the NCAA men's bracket is that the Sooners would be the last team in. 1-1 is chopped towards short. The only play will be the first. Q. No, they got her. It was deep in the hole. Oryk only had one play, and it was to first. Hodge had beat any attempt at second. And Q is retired by a footstep. Here's Riley Boone. Riley Boone 0-2, but has hit the ball hard. And even on the road, the crowd chants Boone. Coleman waits on deck. Here's the first pitch. Boone shows bunt. Missed it. And she committed to it for strike one. She got all the way, almost halfway down the first baseline. As she retreats to the batter's box, digs in deep, slightly open stance. The 0-1. Chop back up the middle. Diving attempt missed by Jennings in the center field. It's an RBI single as Hodge scores from second. Oh, Riley Boone getting it done. It's 5-1 Sooners. Chalk up the 16th RBI of the season for Riley Boone. And here's Jada Coleman.
Batting for the Sooners, number 24, Jada Coleman.
Coleman is 1-3. Hit one that probably didn't have a chance to get out of here, but still an amazing play in left field by Villa, who off the bat it looked like she had taken away a home run. Looked like it might have been at the very least a double or a triple as Coleman takes ball one. Fly out to left and a line out to left. Here's the 1-0 pitch. Coleman takes a little low, ball two. Sooners were shut out in the second, third, and fourth. Put a two-spot up in the fifth on the two-run home run from Alyssa Brito. And manufacture a run here in the sixth to open up a 5-1 lead. Here's the 2-0 pitch to Coleman. Boone off to the races on a pitch high. The throw is not in time. In one hop to shortstop Oryk, who put the tag on Boone just as her foot had hit the bag. Give Riley Boone her fourth stolen base of the season. And now with a 3-0 count, there's a runner in scoring position for Jada. Here's the 3-0. Strike one. Coleman takes a quick step out, but again, you don't have a ton of time. Back in already. Here's the 3-1 pitch to the Sooner center fielder, and that missed inside, ball four. That would have been called a strike. Jada was almost down to first base by the time the catcher had caught it. And we'll get our first circle visit here in the top of the sixth inning. As first-year Texas Tech pitching coach Bryce DeColve wants to slow things down just a bit and talk with Maddie Wright. So the Sooners continue their incredible efficiency in stealing bases. Stolen base today from Ella Parker and Riley Boone. Add one for Alina Torres, too. That wouldn't be Torres. That'd be Avery Hodge as the pinch runner. The Sooners are 36 of 38 in stolen base opportunities this year. First and second, one out. Here's T.R.A. That's a strike. T.R.A. Jennings had not been retired this weekend. She was 5-for-5 heading into this game. She's 0-for-3 today, which means she is due to hit one to the moon. Here's the 0-1. Hard hit ball to short. This could be two to second. Nope, they're only going to have one play, and it's at second to get Coleman. She hit it hard, but it was on the ground, and a nice job staying with it by Oryk. Coleman is retired on the put out at second. Jennings reaches on the fielder's choice. Boone stands at third with two away. And here's Ella Parker.
Adding for the Sooners, number 5, Ella Parker.
Jennings at first. Boone at third. The first pitch to Ella is a little bit in, ball one. Brito waits on deck. Parker on the day is, well, let's double check. I've got her at 1-for-3 as the 1-0 pitch is up high because they had ruled the error. That's exactly it. 1-for-3 with two runs scored and a run batted in. That was back in the first inning. On the season, 26 runs batted in for Ella Parker. See if she can add to that number here. The 2-0 is an off-speed little lollipop change that drops in. Two balls and a strike. I mean, that's one of those pitches that when you see it, you think you should be able to hit that thing a mile. Nope. Leave it alone. The 2-1, hard hit foul. Stop me if you've heard me say a hard hit ball a few times this weekend. Sooners have been knocking the cover off the ball, unfortunately. Tech has had a defensive answer today. Two balls, two strikes. The pitch, Parker. Take strike three. Inning over. On a pitch that looked a little bit low. And Oklahoma adds to its lead as we head to the bottom of the sixth inning. Listen to coverage of the NCAA Championships on the Varsity Network app, powered by Learfield. Fans can hear Westwood One's exclusive national coverage along with most school broadcasts through a multicast option that's only on the Varsity Network app, available for free in your app store. And we'd like to thank our OU community outreach partners, Fowler Auto Group, OU Health, OGD, and Coca-Cola. University of Oklahoma Athletics, 1-1. 5-1 Sooners, bottom of the sixth. First pitch strike to Reagan Jennings. First time this season. And Nicole May has worked into the sixth inning. We had a six-inning gem from Kelly Maxwell Friday night. Here's a slow roller out in front of the circle. Charged by May, the throw to first. Wow, got her. What a play by Nicole May on a day when the Sooners have had a few balls glance off their gloves. A few just odd, non-Sooner-like defensive plays. Nicole May with a gem there, and there's one away.
Adding for the Red Raiders, number 11, Abby Oryk.
Oryk struck out in the second, singled and was forced out at second. In the fourth, 1-for-2. First pitch swinging, and she swings right through it for strike one. Five runs on 7 hits for the Sooners. A run on 6 hits and an error for Texas Tech. Here's the 0-1 pitch. Swing and a miss on a drop. Strike two. No balls, two strikes, the pitch. Wow, just missed. A little bit up. One ball, two strikes. May stares in. Brings home the 1-2. Couldn't stop her swing on a pitch in the dirt. Good job by Ludlam to keep it in front of her. Tagger for the second out of the inning. Give Nicole May strikeout number 6, her 49th K of the season, and there's a quick two away here in the sixth. Kreitz is 0-for-2, reached base in the fourth on a fielder's choice. First pitch, swing and a miss. Want to see these Sooners in person? Your best chance is Friday night in Oklahoma City. Go to Soonersports.com/tickets as the 0-1 is lined into center field, falling fast. It's down for a hit, and it gets away from Jada Coleman. Kreitz off to second. The throw is not in time. That's a rarity on a ball that just got a bit away from Jada. There is a big gap in right center field, and as that ball was falling fast, it just scooted away from Coleman. And here's Logan Holloman, 1-for-2. OU will play in Oklahoma City on Friday night in Hall of Fame Stadium. First pitch is set for 6 o'clock, and the weather is going to be gorgeous. Soonersports.com/tickets. Go now. First pitch to Holloman is lined. Oh, what a play by Alyssa Brito, who leaped and took away a base hit on a line drive down the third baseline. Burrito pounced like a cat and went up and made the play to end the sixth. Wow. We head to the seventh. Oklahoma 5, Texas Tech 1. This is Sooner softball from Learfield. Welcome back to Lubbock. We head to the seventh. Sooners 5, Texas Tech 1. Bob Moore Ford is proud to honor service members through the Patriot of the Game. To nominate a Patriot, visit BobMooreFord.com/hero. And located just 10 minutes from the OU campus, the courtyard by Marriott Norman is competitively priced with travelers in mind. Marriott.com/OKCNO. First pitch to Brito is hammered. Deep to center field. Oh, it's another Brito bomb. A two-homer day for Alyssa Brito. And it's 6-1 Sooners on a no-doubter. An absolute blast. The party is on at home plate. And Alyssa Brito is bringing the vibes. It's 6-1 Sooners on a two-home run day from Alyssa Brito. Oklahoma having a little bit more calculated offensive attack today. Two runs in the first, two in the fifth, a run in the sixth, and a run in the seventh. Here's Sid Sanders. Brito makes the big play to end the third, and then end the bottom of the sixth, and then hits the home run to start the seventh. First pitch ball to Sid Sanders up and in. Sid is 1-for-2 with an RBI and a walk, and she takes the 1-0 pitch low. I was joking with Ryan. Sooners are doing 9-run explosion, and it will probably come in the seventh, just like Friday night. And the next thing you know, you look up, and it's been a 2-hour and 30-minute game. Here's the 2-0 pitch to Sid Sanders. Low, ball 3. And then you have everyone asking, like on Friday night, wait, with that final score of 14-0, why wasn't it a run roll? Because the Sooners put 8 on the board in the seventh. Here's the 3-0 pitch to Sid Sanders with Hannah Kaur waiting on deck. That's a strike. Sanders has that season average up to .388. Pretty incredible run for Sid. Here's the 3-1. Little out in front of it on the off speed, full count. Tip of the cap to Maddie Wright, who the Sooners hit fairly hard on Friday. Kind of like today, it took them a while to really tighten up the reins. Here's the 3-2 pitch. Sanders takes ball 4. I mean, are these people being for real right now? You're complaining about a pitch that's up and in? Come on, guys. I mean, I know 6-1 is about as close as you've been all weekend, but let's be better. Here's Hannah Kaur. Right on Friday night, went 3 innings. Gave up just 4 hits, but of those 4 hits, 3 of them were home runs. Gave up 5 runs, walked 5. She's had much better control today, though it's wild to look down and see that she has walked 5 like she did on Friday night. Here's Hannah Kaur. Sack fly yesterday on a line drive to center field for Kaur, and she takes the first pitch for strike one. The Trails Golf Club in Norman. You'll experience everything you love about golf and more. Learn about spring membership specials and the advantages of belonging to a private club. Check them out online at trailsgolf.com. Runner's going. It's Maya Bland, the pinch runner. She's out. Unless she slid around the tag, she did not. First time this season, and Maya Bland has been caught stealing. Good throw. Credit where credit is due. That was a really nice throw from Kreitz, who has skipped a few today. Just the third caught stealing of a Sooner this season. Here's the 0-2 pitch to Hannah Kaur. Up high. One ball, two strikes. Very exciting whenever you look down and realize that you haven't had to hustle through all your liner cards. 1-2 is bounced to the right side. Nice play by the second baseman, Jennings, who gloves, throws, and gets her, and there's two away. Those five-inning games are great for everybody because, as the T-shirt says, we play five. It would be a hassle for Auburn Phippen to make sure we take care of all of our great partners. Two-way for Avery Hodge. Avery singled her last time up. Scored a run. Has a stolen base here today, too. 6-1 Sooners, top of the seventh inning. First pitch, little bit up. A little bit out, ball one. University of Oklahoma and Sooner Sports Properties would like to thank our concession partners, Anheuser-Busch, Fletcher's Original Corny Dogs, Nashbird, Coca-Cola, The Baked Bear, Community Coffee, Taco Mayo, Boomerang Diner, Schwab Meats, and Uber Eats. Off speed, Hodge shows bunt, pulls it back, but it drops in for a strike. Our OG&E play of the game. You pick whichever home run you want from Brito. Hodge slaps one to third. Diving play made by Love, throws from her knees. Hodge beats it out because McClarity couldn't dig it. It was a big-time play by Love over at third, but couldn't complete the play. As Hodge reaches again. We'll await the scoring. That's a tough error to give. Riley Ludlam's spot. We're going to have a time called as JT Gasso and Patty Gasso are going to come together with Riley Ludlam. And a runner at first. OG&E, we energize life, our play of the game, the Brito bomb in the fifth, a two-run shot, a solo shot in the seventh. It's helped given the Sooners a little bit of breathing room here on what's been a fairly uncomfortable, for the most part, Sunday through four. Sooners put two runs up in the first.
Number 30, Riley Ludlam.
Didn't score again until the fifth. Now they've opened up a 6-1 lead. Meetings are over. Ludlam stays in. She'll hit here. Taped up right pinky and ring finger as the first pitch misses inside. Ball one. Hodge is the runner at first. Pinky in that right ring finger, she jammed on the bag, sliding back in at second on that ball that looked like it was destined for extra bases from Coleman. The 1-0 misses low and away, 2-0. Two balls and no strikes, two outs. We're in the seventh, 6-1 Sooners. Oh, you looking to put a cap on 6-0 start in Big 12 play. 2-0 pitch to Ludlam is low, ball three. Riley walked in the first, flied out to center in the fourth, grounded out to short in the sixth. On the weekend, Ludlam has drawn seven walks. On the verge of drawing her eighth, the 3-0 pitch is not even close, ball four. And with two outs, here comes Riley Boone. This game pushes past the 2 hour and 10 minute mark. Ludlam's going to sport a mitt on the right hand. So a sliding mitt to protect what looks to be a jammed pinky. Good job by Maura Dickman to get her back in this game. First and second, two away. First pitch to Boone. In the dirt, off to third goes Hodge. Off to second goes Ludlam. Aggressive on a ball in the dirt. Second and third now for Boone after ball one low. Boone's one for three on the day. He's driven in a run. And now time is called as the shortstop, Abby Orrick, has come over to say something for Matty Wright. Apparently no one has lunch reservations here in Lubbock today. Here we go. Orrick returns to a fairly straightaway spot at short. Straight up, little in for the infield. Even with the bag at first is McClarity. Here comes the 1-0 pitch. In for a strike, 1-1. Cool overcast, gray skies. The flags in center field. Slightly waved towards right. The 0-1. The 1-1, excuse me, is in for a strike, 1-2. And Matty Wright is just spinning that changeup. One of these Sooners is about to time that thing up like Brito did. Here's the 1-2. Boone takes it high. Coach Gasso, we asked her about Boone on Saturday's pregame show, talked about just how free she seems to be playing, swinging hard. Has a chance to really blow this thing open with runners at second and third and two outs. The 2-2 pitch in the dirt. Good job by Kreitz to keep it in front of her. Ball three. Three balls and two strikes. Wright stares in. The pitch to Boone. Hard hit down the right field. Line fair. Pass the diving McClarity. Scoring is Hodge. Here comes Ludlam. She'll score. It's a two-run single by Riley Boone. And Oklahoma has opened up an 8-1 lead in the top of the seventh inning. A three RBI day for Boone. Have a day, Riley. And long, slow walk to the circle. And we're going to have a pitching change. This crowd, I'm sure, will give a nice round of applause to Wright. This pitching change brought to you by Love's Travel Stops. Love's Travel Stops, the heart of the highway. Bryce DeColvey turns to his pin and turns to Maddie Keel, who... what's the kindest way to put this? The Sooners absolutely destroyed yesterday. Keel didn't register an out. Don't know if this is the direction I would go out of the pen, but Matty Keel becomes just the second Tech pitcher of the weekend. Of the game. Keel's numbers... she did not register an out, gave up six hits, nine runs, and walked three, facing just nine batters in the first inning. The Sooners batted around against Keel and had the game in run rule territory before Sid Sanders mercifully popped out to right field to end it, or to at least get an out. Keel left the game after it was already 8-0. That's not really a good sign to stop the Sooners. Though with two outs in the top of the seventh inning, you never know. Jada Coleman now yesterday on Matty Keel.
Number one, Matty Keel.
Hit the first pitch that Keel threw back up the middle for a base hit. She got a spot right in her zone and ripped it. Boone's at first. Here's Jada Coleman. Coleman on the day is 1-for-3 with a walk. Boone's at first. The pitch in the dirt. Riley Boone with 3 runs batted in today. She has 18 RBI on the season, which has surpassed her season total from last year. The 1-0 is in the dirt. We're only, well, I say only, this season is flying by. We're only in game 28. 2 balls and no strikes with 2 outs. Boone's at first. The pitch to Coleman is up high. Last season, Riley had 14 runs batted in. She came into today's game already at 15. I'm going to go out on a limb and say she'll surpass her single-season career high of 27 here pretty quick. The 3-0 pitch to Coleman is in for a strike. Boone's already homered this season. She has 6 career home runs and a 2-hit day today to open up an 8-1 lead for the Sooners in the top of the 7th inning. Here's the 3-1. All 4. Second walk of the game for Jada Coleman. And here's T.R.A. Jennings,
for the Sooners, number 23,
who
T.R.A. Jennings
hit one out of the yard in a heartbeat off keel the last time that she faced her. First pitch she takes for a strike. The walk of Jada is the 7th walk the Sooners have drawn here today, which means in 3 games, Oklahoma has drawn 28 walks. The 0-1 to Jennings, way outside, 1-1. If or when T.R.A. hits one out of here, I think it's just cruel that they put Maddie Keel back in this game. Just cruel. Here's the 1-1. A little low. I didn't say back in. I mean back in against this lineup. Sooners have now put together 10 hits in this game, which means they've been double-digit in the hit column every game so far. 8-1 with runners at first and second and 2 away. The pitch right on that outer edge, strike 2. I see it working, Bubba Ewald, home plate umpire. Let's get going here. Ball was a little bit out. Fale steal over at first, even a smile at that one. Here's the 2-2 pitch to T.R. In the dirt, gets away from the catcher. Kreitz to the backstop. Off the third goes Boone. Jada Coleman jogs into second. Three balls and 2 strikes. Now second and third, 2 outs. The pitch to T.R.A. is hammered. Deep to center field. It's got a chance. Oh, it's gone! The third homer of the weekend from T.R.A. Jennings is a 3-run bomb, and it's 11-1 Sooners. My goodness. T.R.A. Jennings have a weekend. They're going to be so happy to see her leave Lubbock. It's a 6-run 7th. And some of the Red Raider faithful are heading towards the exits. Don't blame them. The Sooners had an 8-run 7th on Friday. It's a 6-run 7th now. Nobody cares about my 7 o'clock show tonight, Ryan. Nobody. Here's Ella Parker.
Ella Parker.
By the way, Brito waits on deck. T.R.A. gives a little curtain call to the fans. First pitch to Parker is inside. Home runs this season are brought to you by the hardworking people of Oklahoma Oil and Natural Gas. That's a 3-run bomb for T.R.A. Parker takes strike 2. Pardon me, strike 1, 1-1. Ellis singled and drove in a run in the first inning, the first run of the game. Grounded out to first, reached on an error, and was caught looking in the 6th. The 1-1, a little bit low, 2-1. how about this weekend for T.R.A. Jennings? Two balls and a strike. The pitch up high, 3-1. And the fact that they brought back in Matty Keel has got to be like coaching malpractice. I mean, it's mean. What did Matty do to you, coach? Three balls and a strike, but two away in the seventh. Here's the pitch to Parker. Hard hit foul off the netting. Twelve runs batted in over a three-game stretch with three home runs. Unbelievable. The 3-2 pitch to Parker. She gets a piece of it to stay alive. I smell Big 12 player of the week, Thomas. No pressure. Three balls and two strikes. Will be interesting to see if we maybe see Peyton Monticelli come out in the seventh. The 3-2 is ball four. And the Sooners will officially bat around here in the seventh inning.
Batting for the Sooners, number 33, Alyssa Brito.
Eleven to one Sooners. Brito is 2-for-4 and has homered her last two at bat. She takes the first pitch for a strike. Yeah, Toby Baldwin. I heard it from Toby. True MVP is Big Zilla. Always making sure everybody's up to date on the pitch count behind home plate this weekend. Here's our 0-1 pitch. Hard hit through into left field, a base hit. Past Love at third, or it couldn't get there in time. It's a three-hit day for Alyssa Brito. And poor Matty Keel. She still hasn't retired a Sooner. After starting the game on Saturday, Sooners touched up Texas Tech for 12 first-inning runs. Keel gave up nine of them.
Sydney Sanders.
And now she's given up two and has walked two of the four batters she's faced. And oh, ho-hum, here's Sid Sanders. Good cut. Fouled it straight back. Strike one. Sanders. Not a bad day for Sid. 1-for-2 with a run batted in. Two walks. She's upped her season walk total for Sid Sanders to, what is she at right now? 21 as the 0-1 pitch drops in for strike two. Matty Keel has faced 13 Sooner batters without recording an out as the 0-2 is low. One ball, two strikes. The runner at first is Brito. A three-hit day for Brito. Parker stands at second. 11-1 Sooners. Here's the 1-2 pitch to Sanders. Swings and fouls it down the third baseline. Behind Coach Gasso, that rolls all the way to the corner. Well, let's get an update on some of the other Big 12 games. We will have a rather quick Bud Light post-game show. So you guys can get over and listen to Toby and OU baseball team out at Fort Worth. Here's the 1-2 pitch to Sid Sanders. Up high, 2-2. Selection show about to begin for men's and women's basketball. Men's field is announced first. Women's field a little bit later on this evening. Sooners expected to get a 5 seed in the women. 2-2 pitch to Sanders is popped up on the infield, and that'll do it for Oklahoma as McClarity makes the catch. But as Ryan Wondrosik predicted, it is a big seventh inning. A 6-run seventh for the Sooners. They sent 11 batters to the plate, and as we head to the bottom of the seventh inning, Oklahoma 11, Texas Tech 1. This is Sooner softball from Learfield. It is a final in Lawrence. Kansas has swept the weekend from Baylor. They won today 1-0. How about that for Jim McFaul's crew?
For the Red Raiders, number 20,
and
looks
like they've gone final in Stillwater as well. Oklahoma State sweeps UCF with a 6-4 win. Here it's 11-1 Sooners. Carly Keeney's first pitch is swung on by D. McClarity, popped into right field in foul territory. Who else but Riley Boone races over and makes the catch, and there's one away. I'm trying to offer up an update on Aubrey Barnhart. Got hit in the elbow and was done for this game in the fourth inning. There's Ariana Villa. Villa on the day is 1-for-3. That is final now, by the way. Stillwater, Oklahoma State sweeps it. 6-4 was the final score. Score is brought to you by Air Comfort Solutions, your total home solution for plumbing, heating, air conditioning, and electrical. Make the winning call today. 1-0 This is up high to him. Keeney has been fantastic over her last couple of outings, including here last night. She's 2-1 on the season with a 1.40 ERA. 2-0 from Keeney. Fouled off. Went an inning and 2/3 out of the pen. Struck out 2. Didn't allow a base runner in the 6 batters that she faced. And that closes the books for now. Barring a comeback of biblical proportions on one Nicole May. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Ooh, good spot. Strike right on the outer edge, 2-2. 6 innings for May. Scattered 7 hits. Allowed 1 run. Struck out 6. Walked 1. Hit 2 batters. But May in line for win number 9. The 2-2 misses out ball 3 as this game pushes towards the 2-hour and 30-minute mark. Sooners. Crowd claps at the 3-2 is fouled back. Oklahoma is headed home after the game for a Wednesday midweek showdown with UTA. There's a little concern about some lightning for Wednesday night, but everything's looking pretty solid for the weekend. Here's the 3-2 pitch. Hit foul down the left field line and out of play. Texas Tech will travel for a Friday, Saturday, Sunday series. No midweek for the Red Raiders. In Ames against Iowa State, who just won its series over Houston, before they welcome UCF to West Texas in 2 weeks. Here's the 3-2 pitch. Cold strike 3! Keeney got her looking. There's 2 away. Friday night. Look forward to seeing all of you at Hall of Fame Stadium. Tickets available. Get them now at Soonersports.com/tickets. Riley Love, the last hope here for Texas Tech. First pitch from Keeney. Swing and a miss. Love on the day. Walked in the first, singled in the third, and was hit by a pitch in the fifth. Here's the 0-1. Hard hit, right side, foul. There were two moments this weekend where Texas Tech had an opportunity to really make it interesting. Game one, bottom of the sixth inning, bases loaded, nobody out. And a game at that point that was still 6-0, but you never know. Kelly Maxwell set him down in order. Yesterday was an absolute blowout, but they had their chances today. The Sooners shut the door, though. The 0-2 misses outside. And unfortunately, the number that jumps out to us, Cubs, 233.33. That would be the ERA of Maddie Keel. Sooners just lit her up this weekend. Here's the 1-2. Off speed, missed a little bit up. Two balls and two strikes. That's a pitch that Keeney's been working on. High hopes for Carly Keeney. A professional-like approach in the circle. She stares in. She's ready. The 2-2 pitch. Rip foul down the third baseline. Sooners stay the same defensively. Outside of Hannah Kaur, who has checked in left field. Kaur in left, Coleman in center, Boone in right. 2-2. Pop foul again. Two in the first. Two more in the fifth. A run in the sixth. And six in the seventh for the Sooners. 11-1. 14 seventh inning runs this weekend for OU. The 2-2. Off speed. Carter looking. Game over. Win column Sooners. And history for Patty Gasso. Career conference win number 400 for Coach Gasso. No coach in any sport has won more Big 12 conference games than Patty Gasso.